Hi, Ilze. Nice to see you.
Hi, Irina. It's great to see you too.
Last time we talked about the great opportunity to become a Latvian language teacher, and we promised to talk about it more this time.
We can definitely talk about it more this time, but Irina, let me ask you something first.
Yeah, sure. Go ahead.
What was the most challenging thing for you when you started to learn Latvian?
The most challenging thing for me was to distinguish between the short and long vowels. Also, diphthongs were challenging for me. For example, such an easy word in English as to learn can seem long and difficult in Latvian. Iemācīties. Iemācīties. Iemācīties means to learn.
Iemācīties is a great example, Irina, because it is full of diphthongs and long vowels. There are two diphthongs, e, and there is the long vowel a and the long vowel e. But how about we use this word in a short dialogue and teach it to our audience today?
Sure.
Irina, ko tu gribi iemācīties? Irina, ko tu gribi iemācīties? Irina, ko tu gribi iemācīties?
Es gribu iemācīties latviešu valodu. Es gribu iemācīties latviešu valodu.
I asked Irina what she wants to learn, and she answered that she wants to learn the Latvian language. But Irina, there is another word that I would like to draw your attention to, and it is iemācīt. Iemācīt.
That's right. Just another ending, and now it means to teach.
You are absolutely right. The word iemācīt means to teach. The word iemācīties means to learn. Iemācīt and iemācīties. And I teach about these nuances and nuances like that in my course Latvian for English Speakers.
Yes, if you go through Ilze Be's courses, sounds and writings, and Latvian for English Speakers, you can learn these things, and you can learn how to teach them to the others.
That's right. You can not only learn these things by yourself, but you can also learn to teach these things to the others.
And now we say goodbye.
Yes, we'll say goodbye. Till the next time.